18 months. 18 months of waiting. 18 months of praying. 18 months without conceiving. 18 months where I continued believing that my time would come soon. As other bellies around me started to balloon with the beautiful promise of a baby, I told myself this doesn't make me any less of a lady. I cried in the shadows of my bedroom thinking maybe next month, maybe then. But 18 months in, I continue to wait. Best friends come to me with sparkling eyes saying, "Darcy, we've got some news. We are so excited to tell you we're pregnant." Pregnant. Something I am not. Yet something I desire. In those moments, I lift my chin higher, fighting back the tears of my own frustration. I wrap my arms around the girl in honest celebration. I am happy for her, truly. A win for her doesn't mean I can't win too. A win for her doesn't mean I automatically lose. I get that, I do, and that is why, my dear women, I celebrate you. You got your promised child. And through every announcement, I continue to smile. A win for them doesn't mean we can't win too. A win for them doesn't mean we automatically lose. But if I'm honest, it hurts. It feels as if the wind has been knocked out of my chest. And while everyone in the room squeals with glee, I'm there trying to catch my breath. I'm trying to maintain my composure as you start to disclose your announcement. "It just happened so fast," you say. "Only tried for a couple months, and here we are today with a beautiful, precious baby on the way." And in that moment, the number 18 scrolls through my head. And all I want is to climb into the security of my bed, yet the bed still reminds me of what I lack. And my husband crawls in behind me, gently rubbing my back, whispering, "Our time will come. I promise you it will. I know." I let out between sobs of heartache, but it still hurts. And no one really talks about this aspect of the journey, yet daily you're reminded you're approaching 30. At least once a week, people will ask me, "Darcy, when are you gonna have a baby?" And as they see me hold someone else's little one, their eyes light up as they say, "Babies look good on you, hun." People mean well. They absolutely do. But these consistent comments are like salt in a wound. They're continual reminders that my promise hasn't yet come. Even though I started trying before my friends, right now, they are the ones getting their wins. So I have this external joy mixed with internal pain as I show up to your baby shower with a little toy train. And I hold my head high as I continue to try again and again until I can have a baby shower too. Girls, I am so happy for you. I am. But I need you to know what it feels like when I look into your pram. I need you to know what it feels like when your baby squeezes my hand, but by your side, I will continue to stand in celebration, in expectation, and in quiet desperation. To every well-meaning individual that wants to ask me about my plans, please, stop asking me when, because I don't know. We're trying, and for months I've been lying because I didn't want to talk about my feelings of inadequacy while you were just trying to make conversation casually. But in all actuality, I don't need your questions or comments. I just need your prayers, and so do all of the other women who are suffering in silence. Us avoiding the topic is not an act of defiance, but we are simply exhausted from the strain on us mentally when our bodies are failing us physically. We don't need your questions or comments. We just need your prayers for our future heirs, our future promises that will be birthed out of tears. My promise is simply coming the long way round, and in the waiting, worship will be my sound that trails off of these trembling lips as my shaking hands release the script of my life that I had drafted. As my knees fall to the floor in the presence of the one who crafted my own existence, the one who strengthens me in my persistence, the one who rewards me for my continued patience. I choose to offer my life as a platform for his glory, because I know that this is simply a chapter in his greater story. So if you are waiting for your promise to know that I am right here waiting with you.